We see something that said, take a look at what happened.
Hold that in your head,
buddy.
So we gotta move to the
bus.
Let me get my.
Okay, let's move.
What's up?
You fuck with Trump, you fuck with me.
I don't know about you, but I feel infuriated right now. I am angry over what has been done to this man. I see him so differently. Yes, he's got character flaws, of course, but this is the embodiment of strength in the face of an unbelievable onslaught, emotional, financial, free, when it comes to his freedom, and now his life, literally with a bullet having shot him in the head. His fist is in the air and he's telling the crowd and all of us, fight for your country. Fight for what we're all in this for. Don't let them shoot you down. Don't let them shoot down your ideals. Don't let them ruin the country. I've never seen anything like this.
God absolutely had his hand on Trump tonight at that event. If he hadn't have turned his head slightly, he absolutely would have been gone. And I don't care if you love him, hate him, there is no doubting that what happened this evening in Pennsylvania was demonic, it was evil, and it is the product of how twisted and broken society has become in the United States and how everyone is divided against each other. Just like it says in the Bible, a kingdom divided against itself cannot stand. That is what is happening in America. And I don't care if you don't like Donald Trump. Nobody's perfect. I'm not going to go there. You cannot tell me that that man is not a complete warrior to literally have been shot. You can see the blood on his face and his ear, and stand up with your fist in the air and say, fight, 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 fist in the air all the way to the car. Is nothing short of just inspiring, and that is the definition of a leader.
About Joe Biden, I watched his remarks just before I came on, Grant, and I have to tell you, I'm really disgusted, because here's why. Just earlier today on a fundraising phone call, and I'll quote, I want to make sure I get it right, Joe Biden told his donors that it's time to put Trump in a bullseye. Well, guess what? That is exactly what someone did today with their rifle as they attempted to assassinate President Trump. They did exactly what Joe Biden said to his donors on the phone. And let's talk about how this comes on the heels of a weaponized government under Joe Biden and under all the Democrats, because they all support it, a weaponized justice system that is attempting to put President Trump in jail for the rest of his life. And then let's add to the fact that my Democrat colleagues, and I'm going to call them out by name because their names need to be made famous. Benny Thompson, the former chairman of the January 6th committee, just recently introduced legislation to take away President Trump's Secret Service protection. And here's his co-sponsors: Troy Carter, Barbara Lee, Frederica Wilson, Yvette Clark, Bonnie Watson Coleman, Jasmine Crockett, Joyce Beatty, and Steve Cohen. These are the other Democrats that co-sponsored Benny Thompson's legislation to take away his Secret Service protection. So never forget who these people are. Never forget the Democrats. They literally, along with the media, want Trump dead. And that nearly happened today. And we should never, ever forget it. And we will not let this go.
Wish death upon me. Blood in my dog and I can't see. I'm trying to be what I'm